Hi guys, Kanika here and you're watching the K Factor by Kanika Kush. Time now to interview him. Okay, you just saw me getting interviewed. We are still discussing social conditioning and how it affects us. So Adi, I have three questions for you, yep. Like you did for me. The first question is, has social conditioning helped you in any way, in any area of your life?
So let me give a little background. I think I come from a sort of an upbringing where I've been given a lot of freedom to do what I wanted to do. There was no restraint or constraint on anything that I wanted to do. So for me, I was always oscillating between freedom at home versus a lot of questions that the society would ask me. So I was constantly questioning that. So I've grown up being that kind of a personality. I've become a personality which is always questioning questions around social conditioning. Why should we have this? Why should I stay in a job for five years when I can actually just switch in a year?
Who's made the rules? Who's dictating this?
Yeah, I mean, there is God. Why should we go to a temple? I would always question these things. And frankly, I think that was what my background was. And then eventually when we got married, if you talk about what really helped me, marriage and family life and responsibility kind of gave me an understanding of what the benchmark is.
Like the baseline. The foundation.
The baseline of social conditioning. And somewhere, otherwise I'll just go astray, right? I will live it the way I want to live it and not really care about others. Then you become very selfish, rather.
Yeah.
So I think marriage gave me, I question marriage too.
Yeah.
But there is a baseline and it keeps you from, drifting too far. I think that's how it kind of, I think, helped me a little bit. But I still question it, to be honest.
I know you do. So do I. I think that's what we do all day long. Okay. What don't you agree with and why? I mean, is there any specific thing or general thing?
I don't agree with anything that is socio-centric, frankly. I think it's all about what you truly want.
Yeah.
Yes, there is a certain amount of selflessness for the people you love, but it's all about
Not social conditioning at all.
Yeah, it's not.
Love is
a feeling.
Yeah, love is about
somewhere. Even that is for yourself.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I don't think there is anything that I really necessarily agree with.
Okay.
Everything is man-made. Nothing is naturally done.
Yeah, and especially the rules, yeah. And, okay, so my next question is an important one because what happens is that majority of people follow the unsaid rules. Do you think that breaking social conditioning gets you into an isolated state?
There's a thin line, but if you ask me, I think you can make your place. If you can stay away from, the usual, questions and trappings and all of that. And it can make for an interesting conversation in a group of like-minded people. You will be different. You'll be viewed differently.
Yeah.
I've always been viewed creative, different, always have a different opinion, mindset. Maybe earlier I was very argumentative and, forcing my opinion.
You still are.
But I think now I've learned to accept it and let it go and, kind of smoothen in my stance.
Yeah.
It does not create isolation. It depends on how you view it and what energy levels are around it.
So. I think it only brings you closer to like-minded people and there is zero fakeness and pretense and absolute authenticity with even the relationships that you make.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's actually the opposite of isolation.
Yeah, honestly, I have been able to, I think, not convince, I think that's a very strong word, but I think influence positively a lot of my friends who actually come up to me today and say that, this is interesting, the way you think, so can we know more about it, can we talk more about it? So, you gather your own team and,
true.
Build your own little friendships.
That's true.
It doesn't create isolation, it's all up to you.
Yeah. So. Alright, so I think let's wrap that up so that we keep it short, okay? And of course, they're short takes on very, very large topics, but I think that makes sense. So that's about it on social conditioning. And we will see you soon on the next topic. Okay, guys, hang in there, stay safe. Bye-bye. Ciao. Cheers. Bye. Bye.